distinguished speaker. She's here to tell us or give us a presentation on fundamental principles of pharmacotherapy and global resurgence in traditional and complementary medicines, the use of nutraceuticals. That's going to be an interesting topic. This is a person with so much qualifications here. She's a former head and senior lecturer attached to the Department of Dravigna Vignana. Sorry for that misspelled. Material Medica. And she's got a PhD in biochemistry. She's got a master's in plant sciences. Please welcome Dr. Swarna Hapuarachi for this wonderful presentation. She's got 15 minutes to go. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm Dr. Swarna Hapuarachi, BAMA. I'm working as a senior lecturer in the Department of Dravyaguna Vinyana. It's Ayurveda Pharmacology in the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, University of Colombo. Shall I give some brief descriptions of our institute? The Institute of Indigenous Medicine is the premier higher educational institute in Sri Lanka, which produces undergraduates in indigenous medical field. So now it is upgraded to the university and affiliated to University of Colombo in the year 1997. This institute located in Sri Jayawardenapura Kote, the capital of Sri Lanka. At present it produces both Ayurveda and Unani medical professionals to meet the challenging needs of primary health care, health promotions, general health care problems, and disease preventing according to the indigenous medical system. Earlier in previous speaker, Siddha disciplines also attached to the Institute of Indigenous Medicine. The institute admits GCE A-level students in biological science stream who conform to the criteria to recommended by UGC for admission of the university. The currently the selected undergraduates are offered two degree programs, BAMS and the BUMS. It is 6-year course, its duration 5-year academic studies and 1-year internships. The degree program IIM have been designed to produce the Ayurveda doctors who capable of utilizing indigenous LLS, modern diagnostic techniques to treat patients effectively. Our clinical component conducting a national Ayurveda teaching hospital in Borella, in addition to the undergraduate programs, we are conducting postgraduate diplomas and some certificate courses of Ayurveda pharmacy and pharmaceuticals. These are just a brief introduction of our institutes. I'm going to thank the organizers who invited me to do this presentation today. So my topic is fundamental principles of pharmacotherapeutics in Ayurveda and global resurgence in traditional and complementary medicine, the use of nutraceutical. It's vast area, so I want to do a brief description in this given the permitted time. So first of all, I want to give some description regarding the Ayurveda system. So it has the Ayurveda deals with the preventive and curative measures for the well-being of living things. One of the unique approaches of this ancient science is own mission and wisdom to treat each human individually. So nowadays called the personalized medicine. The properties of that exist in the causative factors. It is Karana Dravya. So it consists of Pancha Mahabhuta and Kala, Dik, Atma and Manas. Present in the resultant factor is Karya Dravya, means that exists in matters. I think it is very much similar to the Siddha medicine. In Ayurveda, adopt its own function-oriented approach through the several theories. Pancha Mahabhuta theory, it is consisting of five bhutas. It is Akashavayu, Agni, Prithvi and Jala. These five bhutas constitute the animal body as well as the vegetable and mineral kingdom. It is the physical basis of the body. In Charaka mentioned Sarvam Dravyam Pancha Bhautikam. So according to this theory, similarity and dissimilarity of the constitution of the body tissues and the drugs, or nowadays we are calling medicine, are the basis of drug action, which is either stimulating or brumhana. In Ayurvedic, a technical term is brumhana, or depressing is the langana. Drugs having constitution similar to tissues stimulate them, dissimilar causes a depression. Other one is the Tridosha theory. It is three humors. It is three humors. And three humors, Vata, Pitta, Kapha, and the Sapta Dhatu. Also the Rasa, Rakta, Mansa, Midas, Asti, Majja, and Shukra, and Agni, and Ama, and Ojas, and Shrotas. These are the responsible for the physiological function in the status of homeostasis and for pathological disorders in the imbalance of the main three humors. The composition of drugs, medicine and their properties. In their properties, it is guna, rasa, vira, vipaka, karma and prabhava. Those are described on the basis of Mahabhuta theory. While their actions are described in applied manner on the basis of Tridosha. So the composition, the procedure of pharmacotherapeutics in Ayurveda basically designed with these concepts. Earlier, which I show here, procedures pharmacotherapeutics in Ayurveda basically conducting. Treatment plan. Treatment is planned by physicians, that is Yukti, with the proper administration of therapies in accordance of patient's individualistic doshas. These are the doshas and prakurti, constitutions, body constitution, and vikurti, disease conditions. Each body is believed to determine the unique combination of physical, physiological, and psychological feature of a human. When we are treated to patient in Ayurveda, basically we are considering about the disease state as well as the person state. These are the pain as a prakriti. And as well as with the disease state and the patient states, as well as when we are the dissimilarity and similarity theory, Samanya Vishesha Siddhanta, we are giving the medicine according to the Panchamahabhuta concept as well as the other rasa guna vira vipaka in the all the dravyas. So then Acharya Charaka states a single drug may have many applications owing to its diverse action, just as a man is able to perform various actions. It is called as a synergism or synergistic activity. Herbal remedies consist of portions of plants, or unpurified plants extracts containing several constituents, which are often generally believed to work together synergistically. That's why when we are giving, while we are giving the pata, kashaya or churna, it consists of several number of chemical constituents. All the chemical constituents are working together, not like in Western medicine. Western medicine or modern Western medicine, they are giving the isolated compound to the particular disease. Those compounds having a more, the lot of side effects and other toxic effects. In the Ayurveda medicine or traditional medicine, what we are giving the combinations of compound medicines, all it, those compound having number of ingredients, though some ingredients are having the main activity, some ingredients are balancing the their home the activity. There usually nowadays it is calling as a pH balancing, and give the bioavailability of the those medicine in the body. So these in the our formulas, the combination of the ingredients are very much balancing or homogenized to the final products. That's why the generally calling all the traditional or Ayurveda medicine not toxic to the patients or human beings, but it is not completely true. It has some evidences. If we are giving some formulas, when we are changing formulas with our own self, sometimes it may have the imbalance of the their pH and the efficacy of the final product. The recent resurgence of public interest in herbal remedies has been attributed to several factors, some of which include various claims on the efficacy of effectiveness of plant medicine, preference of consumers for natural therapies, and a greater interest in alternative medicine, erroneous belief that herbal products are superior to manufactured product. That means modern medicine. Improvement in quality, efficacy and safety of herbal medicine with development of science and technology is needful. Patients believe that their physicians have not properly identified some medicinal plants that are the very much needful attention on the during the preparations of Ayurveda medicine as well as the traditional medicine. When we are going to talk about the traditional system of medicine, so traditional medicine of Sri Lanka, now it is very popular in indigenous medicine or the Helavedakama. Where now in the present government also very much interested to the develop the Helavedakama in Sri Lanka. So it is an ancient wisdom tradition of healthcare, and it is a community based system of traditional knowledge that has been developed, preserved and maintained over generation by the local and indigenous communities through their continuous interactions observation and experimentations with their surrounding environment. So in Sri Lanka is proud to claim to be the first country in the world to have established systematic hospitals. Some ancient cities of Sri Lanka, Polonnaruwa, Medirigiriya, Anuradhapura and Mihintale still have the ruins of what many of these hospitals buildings. Sri Lanka has numerous branches. It is so it has numerous branches in indigenous medicine such as fracture healing, kadumbidum vedakama, treatment for snake bite, sarpa visha vedakama, and eye treatment. Svedakama, I will show these things, the treatments of abscess, gedivana pilika, and wounds healing, cancer. Of the traditional medicine. That's why it is local health tradition. That's some Gediwana Pilika or some specific traditional physician, their specificity is in their local area. It is naming that Yatiyana Veda Paramparava. It is localized, specially localized in that particular ethnicity. Actually, it is a type of ethnomedicine. It is a self-reliant in nature. It almost entirely autonomous character because the specific traditional physicians. So they having a specific type of formula using the trial and error base with the experience of their previous ancestors, they are using those formula for the particular diseases because it has their social tradition and these are the cultural values among the ethnic ethnicity. So further, I want to say Sri Lanka has numerous what is called the textures, Sararth Sangraha, Vatika Prakarana, Deshi Chikisa Sangraha, Baisajya Manjusha, Auchana Sangraha, and nowadays Sri Lanka has pharmacopoeia. This pharmacopoeia is the only pharmacopoeia having Sri Lanka. So still now actually we proposed submitted a proposal to the revise this pharmacopoeia. It will be happening in future. In ancients our ancestors, they preserve this medicine using with the disciples with this trial and error basis. There are some religious
You can take one more minute, Professor. You can take one more minute to complete.
Indigenous, these are the Helavedakama. There are some photos I will give more detail. These are our ancient kings you use this Helavedakama and Ravana, these things. And there are some other specific in our traditional system or Helavedakama. There are some Shanti Karma. And some Shanti Karmas we are using my line cutting, healing ritual practices. This is, I call them the specific traditional physicians, the Asvedakama. They are treating for the eye diseases. They are applying medicine in some toes in other part of the area. This is a very particular medical system. So these are the Nadi Vedakama. Our traditional physicians, they are using this Nadi Vedakama. And there are another different types of these branches. So the another particular thing is a practitioner, indigenous medical practitioners, when they are going to prepare the medicine or drug preparation, they first they wish there is a good time, and they are blessing with the divine forces for the trees while doing the preparations. Then rituals or in medicinal preparation to increase the potent of the medicine and give the improve their efficacy. There are some other mantras. Some traditional physicians use mantras to improve their beneficiary in their medicines. Other significance of in Ayurveda and traditional medicine, because it is a natural, it is a polymolecular nature, and it has a safe and like less side effects. So with these our Ayurveda and traditional or Hellaveda Kama, we are they are treating to cure diseases with a single or compound base, and other than the treatment, we are using the prevention of disease to maintain healthy life, and the dietary substance as a nutraceuticals, spices, home remedies, and kitchen garden or indoor garden or outdoor decoration nowadays very popular, because the thing is that our raw materials is diminishing in our natural environment. We have to improve the cultivations of our raw material in the our kitchen garden, indoors and outdoors. So there are nutraceuticals. It is having the herbs, finished herbal products and herbal medicine and herbal preparation. The nutraceuticals in this using for the therapeutic, it has some therapeutic efficacy. There's a limited time I can go fast. Most of the time, the people are nowadays interested to use of nutraceuticals using with herbs. It is very important and a very good future for the Ayurveda as well as our traditional system. These are the things. The development of nutraceutical and traditional medicine present comprehensive coverage and recent advances surrounding phytopharmaceuticals, nutraceuticals, and traditional and alternative system of medicines. There are some the diseases can use for this one. Thank you very much.
So thank you very much, Professor Hapuarachi. That was very thought-provoking, and I learned a new term today called natural. It's like pharmaceuticals and naturaceuticals, and I'm sure Sri Lanka is going to excel in the naturaceutical in the near future. Thanks again, Dr. Professor Swarna Hapuarachi.